Will they be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood? I have a dream.
I was damn grateful to God the case turned out the way it did.
Ooh, so does that mean I get a raise?
Hey, if it was up to me.
Oh, right.
Hey, you're the best cop I got on the force. I know that.
Uh-oh. That means you want something.
Can a guy congratulate a friend on the job well done?
Not with you, Captain. See, with you, there's always an ulterior motive. Mm. Well.
Hey, baby, where you been? Say, what are you and I blowing this joint, huh?
You come up with anything.
Would you believe Franklin's downstairs right now, booking the lot of them?
You made the bust?
Clean as a whistle.
Good girl.
Hey, wait a minute. Does that mean no more hooker get-ups?
Sorry, Kyle. This is your last shot. Tomorrow, I am back in uniform.
I'm gonna waste to cover up those guns.
So, what were the two of you up to while the rest of us are out in the streets fighting crime?
Oh, I was just getting the snow job of the week.
Uh-oh. That means he wants something.
Exactly.
Good luck.
Hey, wait. Okay, let's have it.
I got another assignment for you.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Only this is tough. Gonna have to take on a partner.
Oh, come on, Captain.
Hey,
what are you doing?
No buts now, Kyle.
Okay. Who?
Oh, no.
Nestor?
I want you to meet your new partner.
Oh, come on, Captain, please. You wouldn't do this to me.
Oh,
come on.
Wait just a minute. I don't need this.
I think you do.
Oh, great. I'll do all the work and Masters will take all the credit.
Now, this is your assignment. And I'm sure you two boys can work it out.
You stay out of my way, okay? I've got this one all but wrapped up.
Right. That's why Corelli's assigning you a babysitter.
Surprise!
Well, well. What have we here? Oh, sweetheart, you shouldn't have.
Very funny. It's for you.
You're wasting your time.
Will you get lost?
No. Come on, what's that?
Figure it out.
Well, I was on my way home and I saw it and I just had to get it for you.
This is great.
You like it?
Yeah, come on. You know how I feel about Clouseau.
Yeah, the two of you went to the same school for bumbling detectives.
Nasty, I said get lost.
Sure. Sweetheart, when you're ready for some real action, give me a call.
What is it with the two of you?
Every job has its cross to bear.
I've never seen you when you went at each other's throats. How do you ever work together?
It's a good question. Oh, and Corelli's just assigned us as partners on a new case. I guess it's his way of saying thank you for putting Mary Gardner away.
Great.
Yeah, Corelli's a real prince.
You're both professionals. How bad could it be?
Worse than it looks. Listen, thanks for the poster. I love it.
Anytime.
Hey, I got a great idea. How about you and I finally celebrating together the end of this case? We owe it to each other, you know. How about tonight? I know this great place. It's a funky Mexican restaurant. Okay, it's a dump, but the food is great, and you'll love it. And then right down the street, they have an old movie house that plays nothing but 50s thrillers. They got real popcorn in the works. It'll be great. Come on.
I can't, Kyle. I'm sorry, but I've got other plans. I'm going to Lyric Opera Ball tonight.
Of course. How could I forget? And you wouldn't want to miss out on another fun-filled evening with Big Daddy now, would you?
Yeah?
Oh, nothing more than a little opportunistic dating. I mean, why bother and try working your way to the top when you can go out with the boss and make it there in half the time using half the effort?
If that's why you think I'm going out with Jordan, you are dead wrong. I am committed to my career and I'm going to get there because I deserve it. And if I choose to accompany Jordan after hours, that is my business. I happen to like Jordan. And he happens to like me.
Oh, I'm sure he does. I just think he's putting a little undue pressure on an employee. I mean, you can't very well go and turn down the boss, can you? Otherwise, you might not have a job to come back to.
That is hardly Jordan's style.
Oh, come on, Sam. Who are you trying to kid, huh? Queen of the society pages? That's hardly your style.
That's how much you know. I happen to fit in just fine, which is more than I can say for you.
Oh, so what are you saying? I don't fit in?
You're a cop.
Oh, and you're Princess Di?
Look, go to your Mexican dive. See your stupid B-movie. Enjoy yourself. Obviously, that's where you belong. There's no way you're going to make it to the opera ball unless it's on security detail.
What?
We could hear you all the way down the hall.
Christy, what are you doing tonight?
I'm really looking forward to this.
Well, I'm glad the Opera Committee accepted my offer of the Winston Ballroom for the party. Mm. It's the first big event since the renovations.
It's good publicity.
You better believe it.
You're always looking out for that, aren't you? Looking for new ways to expand business.
Of course, that's the way you build a chain of hotels.
I know, it's wonderful. I mean, I really admire the way you pull everything together.
And I'm going to need your help tonight.
Me? How?
By making the same sizzling impression that you made at the charity dinner.
You've got to be kidding.
No. I thought you conducted yourself very well. I was very proud of you.
Even after I blew up at them about Mary Gardner?
Especially then. Just remember, tonight you're not an employee. Tonight, you're my very special date.
Hey, my shoes, I get more traction.
Oh, she's beautiful. Isn't that Sam from the front desk? Can you believe it?
Miles, you made it after all.
Yes, I was able to close the Cairo deal much sooner than I anticipated.
Marion, you're looking beautiful as ever.
Thank you.
This is Sam Whitmore.
Hi.
Sam, Miles, and Marion Sheridan.
Nice to meet you.
Marion has the meanest backhand in the circuit.
Oh, really? You know, we should get together a doubles match one of these weekends.
You play?
That would be wonderful. Why don't we call you?
Great. Jordan? Bye.
Ciao.
Ciao.
You're just full of surprises, aren't you?
How are you this evening, Mr. Hale?
I'm just fine, thank you, Karen.
I didn't feel much like Mexican tonight.
What are you doing here?
Why, don't I fit in?
Very funny.
You look fabulous.
Kyle, what is this all about?
Oh, I thought it was about raising funds for next year's Lyric Opera season.
You know what I mean. Are you here because of me? Are you trying to prove some point?
Sam.
How did you get in?
If your badge works wonders.
Good, I'll see you inside. Well, Lieutenant, I'd say that I'm surprised, but then again, you have a knack for showing up everywhere.
Well, it is a very special occasion.
I didn't know you were coming. Sam didn't mention it.
Actually, it was a surprise to her, too.
Well, Lieutenant, if you're alone, I...
Oh, Christy, there you are. I'd like you to meet Sam Whitmore and Jordan Hale. This is Christy Russell.
How do you do?
Hi. Well, shall we be going in, honey?
Sure. See you two later.
Look who's here. Sam, shall we go in?
Gladly.
Wasn't that Jordan who just went in?
Looked like it.
With Sam?
Looked like it.
You are fun to dance with.
So we found that out the first evening together, didn't we?
Yeah.
Listen, Sam, will you excuse me, please? There's something I need to take care of.
Of course. Don't tell me Jordan's deserted you already.
Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, Jessica.
Sam, the disappointment you should be concerned with is the one you caused the Itos when you so irresponsibly gave their room. Do you have any idea what you could have cost the hotel?
Look, I've already gotten my official reprimand, all right?
By Jordan? Obviously, he has a different way of doling out discipline.
You don't know anything about it, so why don't you go find your husband and leave me alone?
Be careful, Sam. You're a representative of Hale Hotel now, and what you do reflects on Jordan. That's not something to take lightly. is right. I'm the new director of public relations for Jordan here in Chicago. But of course, he had to beg me. I mean, he felt that this position cried out for someone of celebrity status.
I'd say that Jordan Hale is a very lucky man.
No doubt about it.
Well, thank you, gentlemen. I can't tell you what that does for a girl's ego. But the real question is, will I be able to make a difference?
Fancy meeting you here.
Yeah, well, I could say the same thing, but I can see your wife seems to be making her usual big impression.
Working. PR for the hotel. And you?
Same.
Well, I thought you came with Jordan Hale.
I did. He needed a date, that's all.
Well, some people are reading more into it.
It's their problem.
Miss Whitmore.
Yes.
Jordan Hale pointed you out and asked me to say hello.
Oh.
Corbin Mallory, Chicago Sun-Times.
Nice to meet you.
My. You are every bit as beautiful as Jordan said.
Well, thank you very much. Mr. Mallory, I'd like you to meet Rob Donnelly.
Mr. Donnelly! You've certainly been selling a lot of newspapers lately.
I would have preferred it to have been for different reasons. But if you've got a minute, I would like to discuss that editorial on Daniel Rubens.
Yes?
It was distorted garbage.
What makes you feel that the editorial was distorted, Mr. Donnelly?
I knew Dr. Rubin very well. I worked with him at the university when he made his discovery on Rioxin's lethal side effects, and it just infuriates me that every once in a while, somebody dredges up the past and writes a misleading editorial. They keep criticizing the police for not finding him, when what they should be writing about is the good that Daniel Rubens did. The man was a hero. He saved countless lives by getting that drug off the market.
A hero to some, maybe. But the man did break the law.
No.
Wait a minute. He was responsible for an explosion that took the life of an innocent man.
Nobody was ever able to prove that. The man was a scapegoat. Daniel Rubens had the guts to take a stand against a very powerful pharmaceutical company.
Will you excuse me, gentlemen?
If you feel so strongly, why don't you write a rebuttal to my editorial?
I may just do that.
I doubt if it'll change anybody's mind. Only Rubens can do that. But I've always felt that my newspaper was a leader in freedom of the press. So, you write it, I'll run it.
Mr. Mallory, you've got yourself a deal.
Having a good time?
Fabulous.
Interesting people.
Very.
I'm surprised to see the lieutenant here. Doesn't seem like the kind of affair that he'd be interested in.
Well, you never know with Kyle. Maybe he's working.
Front of desk. Look, I'm sorry, but I must see no alternative. Would you please ask Mr. Hale to come up to my suite immediately? There's a problem only he can handle.
He always feels he has to check in with the station. You know, cops.
Not really, but you seem to. Have you known him long?
Oh, years.
Couldn't help noticing you dance, you two.
The dips? That's Kyle for you, always full of surprises.
Well, well, should my ears be burning?
To say the least, your earrings should be smoking by now.
Funny girl, you notice that?
Yeah.
You two enjoying yourselves?
Very much. The party is wonderful, and what you've done with this hotel is incredible.
Excuse me, Mr. Hale, there's a problem with the guest on 15. He demands to see only you. Jordan, would you like me to handle it for you?
No, thank you, Jessica. I'm sure it won't take long. Will you excuse me, Sam?
Of course.
Thank you.
interest you in a dance?
What happened to Christy?
She's in the ladies' room.
Just someone's bid for attention. I saw through it. But thanks for keeping Sam company. Shall we, my dear?
Jessica, I got you everything you asked for. Don't you like your office?
It's wonderful. Thank you so much for your trouble.
Just doing my job. You know something? You looked lovely last night at the ball.
It was a very successful party, wasn't it? I mean, it was
certainly good PR for the hotel.
I was surprised to see Lieutenant Masters there.
Well, he's an opera buff.
Somehow I doubt that. Maybe soap opera, so? I guess he felt he couldn't refuse your invitation.
I didn't invite him. I was with Jordan, remember?
Oh, yes. It was quite obvious.
Want to get to the point? Sam, I want us to be friends.
Really?
Yes, I do. We're working together now, and it seems to me the only sensible thing to do. I certainly know Jordan would like it.
I suppose that would be the professional thing to do, but I'm a little surprised. Are you really serious about this job?
Oh, yes, I am, very. But what about you?
Or is this just a way to get yourself invited to fancy balls?
Look, I'm trying to build a career here, Jessica. I'm hoping it'll be in the hotel business.
Wonderful, Sam. That's exactly what I wanted to hear.
I don't think you asked me up here to discuss my career aspirations.
Well, that's true. But you see, I had to be sure first where you stand on this particular job.
Well, now you know. Sam?
Now, I hope you don't mind this. But I would like to give you some advice. Rather, I would like you to profit from my experience.
And, which experience is that, Jessica?
To Kyle.
Hello?
Christy, what are you doing in uniform?
I'm on my way to court, remember?
Boy, you are out of it today.
Don't suppose I have to wonder why. Sam, isn't it? You want to give me some advice. This should be classic. I can hardly wait.
I've had a bit more experience in these things than you.
What is this experience you keep talking about?
Mixing business
with pleasure. Oh, Sam, I learned a very painful lesson dealing with my producer, Leonard Cooper. It cost me my job on Tomorrow's Another Day.
It was much more than just your relationship with Leonard Cooper, and you know it.
Please, Sam, just listen to me. What I'm trying to tell you is I thought I could trust Leonard. I thought if we were close, it would help me.
But the whole thing backfired.
When I said no to him, that was the end of my job. And Sam, I see the same thing developing with you and Jordan.
Is that it?
I'm giving you very good advice here. Don't play where you work.
You're way out of line, Jessica. First of all, you can hardly compare your relationship with your producer to mine and Jordan's. You are a desperate actress. I'm hardly desperate. And if I'm going to make it, it's going to be because of my brain. Nothing else.
Oh, Sam, you are so wrong. The circumstances are exactly the same.
Okay. Then let's just say it's none of your business.
You're wrong there, too. I've known Jordan a long time. I know him a lot better than you do.
Look, you're trying to get at something. So why don't you just spit it out?
All right. Don't get emotionally involved with him. Oh, I know you're attracted to his exciting lifestyle, but who wouldn't be? Sam, if you think going out with Jordan after work is going to ensure you a higher position at the hotel, you're very much mistaken.
You do have such a devious mind, Jessica. I mean, did it ever occur to you that I might have gone with Jordan because I think he's a nice man and I enjoy his company?
No. That may be what you'd like to believe. But I've known this man a long time. I've seen a lot of women come and go in his life, leaving no memory. Oh, Sam, you'll only get hurt, personally and professionally.
Thanks for the warning.
Oh, don't feel badly. You're young and attractive. You'll find somebody else. Maybe someone closer to your age, like Lieutenant Masters. He's obviously attracted to you.
Stop patronizing me. You know, if you weren't married to Rob, I think you were jealous of me and Jordan.
Sam, that is hardly the case. I'm just trying to save you some anguish.
Or are you speaking from past experience? Are you one of those women who have come and gone in Jordan's life? Are you just a memory, Jessica? You advised me not to get involved with Jordan, but by the look of things, the name on your door in this office hasn't done you too badly, has it?
What are you doing?
Checking to see if you're alive.
Scram.
Scram? You spend too much time watching old movies, Kyle.
Yeah, but you knew it was Edward G. Robinson.
Big deal. Now, don't get me off the subject at hand here. I'm serious. You have got to get out more like last night. I had a great time.
I appreciate you coming on such short notice.
What are friends for? You know, Kyle, all the years I've known you, I've never seen you go to so much trouble for a woman before. Rented tux, 2 tickets to the opera ball.
It's a worthy cause.
Whose? Yours? Of course, she may be worth it.
What are you talking about?
Sam's a beautiful young woman.
I guess.
Come on, Kyle. It's me, your old buddy Christy. Admit it, it's okay, you know? This kind of thing happens to the best of us. Even a tough guy like you.
Christy, you're making too much of this Sam thing. She's just another pretty face.
Why are you fighting this, Kyle?
It's okay to be head over heels.
Head over heels? Me? No way.
You are fooling yourself, buddy boy. You've gone to a lot of trouble for this lady. I know the way you conned Jordan Hale to get him out of the room just to have one dance with her. Admit it, sweetie. You're gone. Well, I think it's great. So does Brad.
You told Brad?
He is my husband.
Oh, and I'm sure he got a great big laugh out of it too, right?
Of course not. We love you. And we both think you should have another life outside of these walls. This one's a little bit different, isn't it? Jordan Hale is stiff competition.
I like a challenge. Makes life more interesting.
You live with that every day in your job. Why would you want it in your personal life? Can't you find someone a little less challenging?
I didn't exactly go looking for Sam. It kind of crawled under my skin.
Takes a pretty special person to put up with us cops, you know?
That's true.
No. All through the police academy, you, Brad, myself, we were close because we understood one another. We could deal with the lifestyle. But what about Sam? Really think she could handle it?
If I could just get her away from the razzle-dazzle of the hotel business, I could find out.
Like I said, it wouldn't be a bad idea for you to get away from your job, either. I just made a lasagna last night. We could heat it up. Brad and I will be at your place at 7.
What?
All you have to do is toss a salad. Put some garlic on a loaf of Italian bread, and presto, dinner in Positano. Oh, and bring Sam, or anyone else you want. I don't care. But you are going to forget this place tonight, and that is an order, Lieutenant.
Do you see this stack of work on my desk?
See you at 7.
Sam, my secretary went home. I just got a call from New York. I have an emergency meeting. I have to leave tonight. Can you handle the arrangements?
Oh, of course. I'll be happy to.
Fine. I want you to call the ad agency in New York. Tell them I'm coming in. We'll have a meeting tomorrow afternoon. Then call the airport. Advise them that I'll be taking the Hale jet. I want to take off at 8 sharp.
Anything else?
No, I think that'll be all.
Not to worry, Mr. Hale. I'll take care of everything. I'll have your limo pick you up here at 7 and arrange a car to meet you in New York. Where would you like to dine tomorrow night?
Oh, of course. Four Seasons. Now, when you call, they're going to tell you reservations are impossible. You tell Tom it's for me. You won't have a problem.
Got it.
Oh, and make it early. I'm going to the Philharmonic. I want 2 tickets.
I'll take care of it, sir. Just make sure you're here at 7 o'clock. Have a wonderful time.
Mr. Hale? Do you think she can handle all that?
As a matter of fact, I do.
Well, I hope you're right.
Sam, she was one step ahead of me all the way. She just needs a little push now and then. She's very bright, she's energetic, everything I look for in an employee. I think she can handle anything. And anybody.
Well, looks like she certainly handled you.
Hi.
Hi. How's it going?
Crazed. Mr. Hale's got me jumping. Oh, hey, I saw Maya leave earlier. She seemed thrilled about her new job.
Sam, what is it with the women that I fall for?
What now?
You know, something strange is going on with Maya. There's something that she's not telling me.
Oh, God, Adam, not another mystery woman. Well, hi.
You got a minute?
Sure, but only a minute. I've got some arranging to do on Mr. Hale's schedule.
Did you have fun last night?
Glorious. And you?
Oh, yeah, it was pretty nice.
So did Misty enjoy herself?
Christy? Oh, yeah, she had a great time. She loved it.
How long have you been seeing each other?
Oh, several years. We met in the police academy, and we've been real close ever since.
How nice.
Yeah, she's a lot of fun.
Yeah, she says the same thing about you. Look, I've got a lot of things to do.
Oh, I understand. Hey, Sam, are you busy later?
Well, I've got to stick around here until 7. Mr. Hale's leaving for New York.
Really?
Yeah, he's flying out tonight.
Too bad. Listen, how about after he takes off? Maybe dinner?
You, me, and Christy? How cozy.
Actually, Christy will be there with Brad.
Brad?
Her husband.
Husband?
Yeah, he's another cop. Sam, they're my best friends. I think you'll like them a lot. I just thought we'd have dinner at my place. This way I'd give you a chance to see how the other half lives.
Cops are really sneaky, aren't they?
Whatever works. So, don't forget the address. And 7:30, okay?
This isn't a trick, is it?
No. No, this is a very real invitation from a guy who just wants to get to know you a little better.
I'll see you at 7:30.
Problem?
No. In fact, things could be better.
Well, they're terrific.
Really?
Look, I know what you're thinking, but we've worked things out.